Installation of a Roxtec GKO transit. To install a Roxtec GKO transit, you need the Roxtec GKO frame components, as well as Roxtec RM sealing modules, Roxtec stay plates, the Roxtec wedge with wedge clip, and Roxtec lubricant. The GKO frame components are the two long sides, the short sides with attached gaskets, and the midwall. You assemble the frame components around routed cables using the supplied fasteners. When assembling the frame components, just mount and attach all fasteners loosely. Only tighten them as a last step when all parts are assembled. Remember to verify that the gaskets protrude or are at least flush with the frame to ensure tightness towards the structure. A GKO transit is often used in a wide variety of structures. The frame must be attached to the structure in line with guidelines using suitable gasket and fasteners. You can seal openings for both cables and pipes in different structures, such as concrete, steel, gypsum, or sandwich walls or floors. The installation procedure is similar for most rectangular seals. This example shows a Roxtec GH transit. Prepare the frame opening. Clean the inside surfaces of the frame. Lubricate the inside surfaces of the frame especially into the corners. Insert cables or pipes. Feed the cables or pipes through the frame opening. Adapt the modules. Adapt the modules by peeling off layers. Achieve a 0.1 to 1.0 mm gap between the two halves when held against the cable or pipe. The number of layers may not differ by more than one between the corresponding module halves. Lubricate all sealing surfaces on the modules. Lubricate the sealing surfaces of the spare modules. Do not remove the core. Install the modules. Insert the modules according to your packing plan. Start with the largest cables or pipes and place any spare modules close to the wedge. Place a stay plate on top of every finished row of modules. Ensure that the modules are secured within the stay plate edges. Continue to fill the opening for cables and pipes with modules and stay plates. Before inserting the final row of modules, insert two stay plates. Separate the two stay plates and insert the final row of modules between the stay plates. Drop the upper stay plate on top of the modules. Prepare the compression unit. Fully untighten the screws to decompress the wedge. Lubricate the short sides of the wedge. The wedge face marked stay plate this side shall face a stay plate. The stop flanges shall face the frame. Tighten the seal. A Roxtec pre-compression tool can be used to make room for the wedge if necessary. Insert the wedge and make sure it is accommodated and secured by the stay plate. Tighten the screws alternately until full mechanical stop. The wedge will compress and seal the transit, and the excess lubricant will be squeezed out. Excess lubricant is a sign of good compression. Attach the wedge clip to the wedge screws to complete the installation. Make a final check. Different approvals or certificates may include amendments or limitations related to the application. Always read the installation instructions supplied with the product. disassembly and reinstallation. Remove the wedge clip from the wedge. Untighten the screws alternately to full stop. Insert a flat tool between the wedge and the stay plate to simplify removal of the wedge. Lift the stay plate. Remove the modules required. If needed, use a flat tool. Replace any damaged modules. Continue the reinstallation of a new cable or pipe. Clean the exposed ceiling surfaces. Lubricate the exposed ceiling surfaces. Lubricate the corners thoroughly. Adapt, lubricate, and install the modules. And then tighten the seals.